Check two, one, two. Well, folks, we're about to get started with our Maine and Jupin show here for the 2023 Cattlemen's Congress. If you would, let's take a minute and remove cover and pay tribute to our flag. What a great way to start the morning. We'll get started here momentarily with our female show. Our judge for today's pin show is Mr. Sean Wilson. Sean, along with his wife Stacy and sons Jace and Caden, own and operate SW Cattle Company, a seed stock operation based at Strathmore, Alberta, and La Rosse, Saskatchewan. Sean works along with his father, Bill. His parents, Bill and Judy, started Wilson Stock Farms, Maine as you heard, in 1972. This spring, they will be calving approximately 300 Maine and Jew, Maintainer, and Angus females. They annually market the top cut of their bulls in late March on team auctions in their Maine bull sale. This will be their 19th annual selling 100% online bull marketing opportunity. We're glad to have Sean with us today. We'll get started with class one. Okay, we'll get started here with our first class, brought to you by Simmons Cattle Company, Trey Simmons. The first heifer in the ring is third there on your program. This is TTTS Kyla, 23K. She's a May 22nd of 2022. She weighed 837, scanned with ribeye of 11.2 and an IMF at 5.3 with a back pat of 0.4. Again, this is TTTS Kyla. Many of these animals in the pen show today will be selling in our Bright Light sale later on this afternoon. Kyla is actually lot 52. If you happen to have your catalog, you can follow along there as well. The second heifer coming in is TTTS Carrie, 33K. She's a May 7th of 2022. Weighed 787, scanned with an eye at 12.6, had an IMF of 4.1 and a back fat at 0.2. Carrie will be lot 50 in our Bright Lights sale. The pen average for weight per day of age is 3.14. Our final member of this pen is TTTS Kyra, 22K. She's a May 15th of 2022, weighed 802, scanned with an eye of 10.7, had an IMF of 4.8, and a scan with a back fat of 0.2. TTTS Kyra is also lot 51 in the Bright Light cell. So there is two entries in this first class in our High Main Pen Show. Our next entry will be brought to you by Ebersole Cattle Company. The first heifer in is ECC Freya, 225K. She's an April 15th of 2022. weighed 897, skinned with a ribeye of 12.0, an IMF at 3.9, and a back fat of 0.2. The pen average weight per day of age is 3.17. Also, ECC Freya is lot 55 in our bright light cell. If you are looking at your show program, this would be the heifer in the middle on the pin list. The second heifer coming in for Ebersole is ECC Blackbird 222K. She's an April 10th of 2022, weighed 886, skinned with a ribeye of 11.8. an IMF at 4.0, and a back fat at 0.2. ECC Blackbird is also lot 54 in our bright light cell. And the final member of this pen is the heifer that is third on that list there. This is ECC Kelsey 224K. She is a May 10th of 2022, weighed 846, skinned with a ribeye of 11.3, had an IMF of 8.5, and a back fat at 0.4. Again, the pen average weight per day of age was 3.17 for the entry from Ebersole Cattle Company. ECC Kelsey is also lot 56 in the bright light cell this afternoon. We will be bringing our two entries in from this class before Judge Wilson will place them and critique them. Thank you for joining us this year, both live and online, here for the 2023 Cattlemen's Congress Maine As You Pinch Show. We are glad to be back here in Oklahoma City, and I would like to take a second to recognize one of the driving forces in the Cattlemen's Congress and major player in our leadership here in Oklahoma, Mr. Jimmy Harrell, over to my right. Jimmy, can you wave your hand? We appreciate all of Mr. Harrell's hard work in making this happen. Let's give him a round of applause, please. Thank you, Jimmy.
Test. Well, first of all, I have to give thanks to the association, Blake and Josh and the board for inviting me down here to Oklahoma City to join you guys today. Our operation is just a few miles north of here, but by the quality that we've seen in this first class, it doesn't look like it's going to be an easy job today, but by saying that, I think it's going to be easy because regardless of where I place them, I think we're going to have good cattle that when they come out on the end. We started with this pen here. In my opinion, maybe heifers that fit together a little bit more in type. Quality from top to bottom of the three individuals is very consistent. I think heifers that are really fluid in their structure, they get out, they've got some longevity in terms of their structural correctness and their integrity as they get out on the travel. I think heifers that I really appreciate for their straightness of their lines and their depth when you get in beside them, and as I said, they get out and they move extremely well. I think the class in second in class heifers, females, you must really appreciate. There's two heifers that are a little bit more unique in their design, a little longer bodied heifers, got some length of body, some stretch to them. And the Tag 56 heifer, I think, is a really good individual, a little bit more modern in her type, but I think three heifers, once again, fit together, maybe not quite as consistent in their type compared to the class winners, but I think overall six heifers that we really appreciate. Congratulations, exhibitors. Look forward to seeing more cattle as we come forward, and let's congratulate these folks as they take these cattle out of the ring.
Thank you, Sean. So results of our first class. First place went to entry 40600, brought to you by Simmons Cattle Company, Trey Simmons. In second place was entry 40601, brought to you by Ebersole Cattle Company. We'll bring in class two here and then see those cattle later on for our champion drive. We just have one entry in class two. Okay, our entry in class two is entry 40602, brought to you by DeYoung Ranch. The first animal in would be third on your list there, DJ Cat K210. She is a March 1st of 2022. She weighed 947, scanned with an eye of 13 and an IMF 4.2. This pen had a pen average weight per day of age of 2.65. Also, DJ Cat K210 will be lot 46 in our bright light cell. Okay, the second heifer coming in is actually the middle heifer on your pin list. This is DJ Kit K10. She's a February. All right, we're back. So this is DJ Kit K10. She's a February 28th of 2022. Had a weight of 896, a ribeye at 10.7, and IMF at 4.1. The third entry here in the young pen is DJ Candy K21. She's a February 3rd of 2022. She weighed 901, skinned with a ribeye of 11.2, had an IMF at 4.0 and back fat at 0.2. Again, the pin average weight per day of age was 2.65.
I think class two, these heifers definitely could stand some competition. Females, I think overall, really fit together extremely well. They've got some width to base. The heifers get out and they travel extremely well on all four corners. I think as you analyze, when you get in beside these heifers, they've got some depth to them. They've got some shape. Really had to have to appreciate the quality from of all three individuals. And as we said, definitely could stand some stiff competition, but let's congratulate these exhibitors bringing these heifers out to us here today.
Congratulations to entry 40602, brought to you by DeYoung Ranch, Kennebec, South Dakota. Next in, we'll have class three, brought to you by Meyer Main Anjou. The first heifer in would be third on your pin list there. This is MMA Simrose 242K. She's a January 17th of 2022. She weighed 760, scanned with a ribeye of 12.1, had an IMF of 3.3, and a back fat at 0.2. She is the third one on your list. The next heifer in will be first on your pen list. This is MMA Empress 250K. She's a January 2nd of 2022. She had a weight of 858, scanned with a ribeye of 12.4, an IMF at 3.7, and a back fat at 0.2. Again, this is MMA Empress 250K. Okay, the final member of the pen for Meyer, Maine, and Jew is on the middle of your pen list. This is MMA Hannah, 232K. She's a January 9th of 2022. She had a weight of 743, scanned with a ribeye of 11.2, an IMF at 3.3, and a back fat at 0.2. Again, this is MMA Hannah, 232K.
Once again, as we class three heifers, a set of full blood heifers that come to us, I think females you must really appreciate for their length of body, the width when you get in behind them over their top. I mean, this is kind of fact and reason why these Maine cattle over time have shown why we have such good rib carriage and rib shape and ribeye size when you see these full blood females that come to you with the data that they come to us with today. I think there's two females that kind of step ahead a little bit more than the one heifer is a little bit more hollow in her makeup, but I think heifers that fit together, get out and travel extremely well and fluid in their stride. Maybe not quite as eye appealing as some of the heifers we've seen earlier, but you must really appreciate these heifers for their volume and their power. And I think, once again, let's congratulate these exhibitors for bringing these females to us here today.
Okay, congratulations to entry 40612, brought to you by Meyer, Maine, and Joux. We will now bring back our class winners for our champion, Maine and Joux, Pen of Three Female Drive. For our champion pin drive, our respective class winners, the pin to my right is our winner out of class one, brought to you by Simmons Cattle Company, Trey Simmons, entry 40600. Directly in the middle is our winner out of class two, entry 40602, brought to you by DeYoung Ranch. And then our pin, class winning pin out of class three to my left is entry 40603, brought to you by Meyer, Maine, and Joux. Again, our pin judge for today is Mr. Sean Wilson. Sean, along with his wife Stacy and sons Jace and Caden, own and operate SW Cattle Company, a seed stock operation based at Strathmore, Alberta, and La Rosse, Saskatchewan. Sean works along with his father Bill. His parents, Bill and Judy, started Wilson Stock Farms, Maine and Joux herd in 1972. This spring, they will be calving approximately 300 Maine and Joux maintainer and Angus females. They annually market the top cut of their bulls in late March on team auctions in their The Maine Bull Sale. This will be their 19th annual sale that is 100% online.
I think first, before we get to picking our champions in this and the female high percentage division, let's congratulate these people. I know how much work it takes to get these cattle presented. I know there's people out here probably got people back at home, thawing out waters, pushing snow, feeding cows. So I don't take this lightly. I think as we analyze these cattle, I'm going to try to pick cattle at how I'd be sorting females at home. I mean, the ones that I'd want to kind of sort to the top of my replacement pen. I'm going to sort these cattle, I guess, for me today. I appreciate the data that these cattle come to the ring with today. I think they're very consistent in terms of the ribeyes and the marbling, the IMF numbers, performance. Presentation of these cattle is top-notch, and I think to that, I congratulate the exhibitors. As we went through the cattle, I kind of talked to them, and I think as the heifers, when I start analyzing and kind of sorting them through for what I look like, what we kind of want to use in our operation, I'm going to use the heifers that come to us in class two as your champion pen. I think when you analyze them, they probably have a little bit more power, a little bit more substance compared to the heifers in the division. A couple of really good individuals in here. Maybe one heifer that isn't quite as stout, but I think she's still a heifer that's very good in her own right. But I just think heifers have got a little bit more power and mass to kind of lead them to the front of the class. And then we'll follow up with class one as your reserve pen. I think females that are very unique and very consistent in their type and their quality. There's heifers you must really appreciate for their femininity and their stretch and their straightness of their lines. Maybe just get outpowered in terms of power and performance compared to the heifers ahead of them. But I think a really nice set of females. Overall, let's congratulate everybody again and look forward to seeing the bulls here.
Congratulations to our champion pen of three females goes to the Young Ranch of Kennebec, South Dakota, and reserve went to Simmons Cattle Company, Trey Simmons. Many of these females, again, will be in our Bright Light sale this afternoon. We'll take just a quick break for pictures and then pick right back up with our high main pen of three bull show. Okay, folks, well, we'll get started with our pinball show here momentarily. We will start with class four. You have two entries in this class. Again, our judge for today in our pin show is Mr. Sean Wilson. Sean, along with his wife Stacy and sons Jason and Caden, own and operate SW Cattle Company, a seed stock operation based in Strathmore, Alberta, and La Rosse, Saskatchewan. Sean works along with his father, Bill. His parents, Bill and Judy, started Wilson Stock Farms, Maine, as you heard, in 1972. This spring, they will be calving approximately 300 Maine and Jew maintainer and Angus females. They annually market the top cut of their bulls in late March on team auctions in the Maine bull sale. This will be their 19th annual sale, and they're selling approximately 100% online now. We're glad to have Sean with us today. We'll get started here again with class four on your programs. These bulls will be coming in order as they're listed on the program. 1, 2, 3 there. The first bull is OHL Cabane, 4192K. His date of birth is March 6th of 2022. He weighed 1,078, skinned with a ribeye of 14.4, had an IMF of 3.3, a scrotal at 35, and back fat at 0.2. OHL Cabane also is lot 29 in our Bright Lights bull cell. The pin average weight per day of age for Ulrich's pin is 3.28. The second bull coming in is a three-quarter blood Maine bull, OHL Kahuna, 4127K. He's a March 15, 2022. He weighed 1,021, had a ribeye of 14.7, an IMF of 3.3, a scrotal at 30, and back fat at 0.2. OHL Kahuna is also lot 30 in the Bright Light cell. Here comes the final member of the Ulrich's pin. It is third on your list. This is OHL Kaboom, 4226K. He's a March 23rd of 22, weighed 1,016, scanned with an eye of 14.7, had an IMF of 3.6, a scrotal at 31, and back fat at 0.2. Again, the pin average weight per day of age for Ulrich's pin is 3.28. Entry 40607 is brought to us again once today by Wayne and Barb Ulrichs. They own and operate Ulrichs Cattle Company in Norfolk, Nebraska. They offer show heifers through online sales as well as private treaty and in the fall on show circuit online. They hold an annual bull sale every February. The majority of our pen cattle folks are stalled at the west end of Barn 4. If you want to make your way back to the stalls, look at them after the show. They also will be available for viewing in our preview there before the bright light sale at approximately 2 p.m. this afternoon. Next in will be our second entry in class four, entry 40608, brought to you by Buck Morton Cattle Company. The first bull in is first on your list. This is BKMT Classified 12K. His date of birth is February 25th of 2022. He weighed 1,210 pounds, scanned with a ribeye of 14.0. An IMF at 3.4, had a scrotal at 37 and a back fat at 0.3. The pen average weight per day of age for this pen is 3.54. The second member of this pen is on middle on your list there. This is BKMT King of Hearts, 14K. He's a March 24th of 22. He weighed 1,012 pounds, scanned with an eye of 12.8, had an IMF of 3.3, measured with a scrotal of 30, and a back fat at 0.2. BKMT King of Hearts, 14K, is also lot 28, and our Bright Lights bull sale this afternoon. The next bull in is third on your pin list. This is BKMT Kingsman 02K. He's a March 12th of 22, weight 1107, scanned with an eye of 13.6, an IMF at 3.9, had a scrotal at 36, and a back fat at 0.3. BKMT Kingsman 02K is also lot 27 in our Bright Light cell. And once again, the pin average weight per day of age for this group was 3.54. This pin was brought to us by Buck and Morton Cattle Company. It's a partnership between two operations that are like-minded in terms of producing high-quality Maine-Anjou seed stock. The partnership started with Morton purchasing a set of Maine cows, which laid the groundwork for a near 30-year working relationship. In 2012, Buck and Morton decided to turn up production and hired Brett Carter to manage the partnership females. With an ever-growing donor battery and the heavy use of AI, IVF, and embryo transplant, it has allowed the program to grow from 22 cows in 2012 to near 400 cows today. Priding themselves on being a consistent source of high-quality, maternal-oriented, high-percentage Maine-Anjou seed stock. The Buck and Morton program is forever a work in progress to stay in the forefront of the breed.
All I can say is, wow. You got to drive a lot of miles to look at quality quite like this. And I think to that, let's congratulate these exhibitors. It's a really good set of six bulls here in front of us today. I think by no means do I look at data all the time, but I think someone told me, a commercial guy told me the other day, that he wears glasses because he said glasses are like looking at data or EPDs. The more information you can get, the better decisions you can make. And I think phenotypically, you really have to appreciate these bulls. Some of the data, I think the ultrasound data on these bulls is really impressive. Obviously, both pens of bulls have individuals that I'd like to see a little bit more scrotal in, but these bulls are still young, and I have to appreciate that. The one set of bulls probably carries a little bit more condition than the other set of bulls. But by no means am I here to judge who gets them better, who gets them fed. I'm looking at the cattle, and I think with that, as we dissect through them, I think overall the set of bulls that come right here are going to win the class. I think just top to bottom, I think the three individuals fit together a little bit more uniform in type than the bulls that are in front of them. But by no means, there's some very good individuals in both pens, and I think later today or tomorrow, whenever these bulls sell in this bull sale, that's what pays the bills. In my opinion, and in our operation, what the value of these cattle is where it sits. And sometimes, by no means is how I'm out here sorting these cattle, make your decisions on what works in your operation. But we're going to use this pen, as I said, in first, and the other set of bulls I really appreciate. Maybe one bull in there, I'd like to maybe loosen them up a little bit, give them a little bit more stretch. But I think overall, we're going to be really critiquing here, but I think overall, top to bottom, two really good sets, and really appreciate the quality. And let's congratulate these operations as they leave the ring.
Okay, congratulations to Ulrich's Cattle Company on their class winning pen entry 40607. And second place went to Buck Morton Cattle Company with entry 4608. Next in will be class 5 of our Maine Anjou pen of 3 bulls. Class 5 has 3 entries. Our first entry is brought to you by DeYoung Ranch. These bulls will also be coming in order, 1, 2, 3. So the first in will be DJ Knockout, K221. He's a February 7th of 2022. He had a weight of 826, scanned with a ribeye of 12.7, an IMF at 3.2, a scrotal of 29, and back fat at 0.2. DJ Knockout K221 is also lot 7 in our Bright Lights bull sale. Bull in the ring now is DJ Kodak, K222. He's a February 11th, 2022. He weighed 806, had a ribeye of 11.2, an IMF at 3.3, a scrotal at 30, and a back fat at 0.2. DJ Kodak is also lot 8. And our final entry in this pen is DJ Kahuna, K220. He's an April 9th of 2022. He had a weight at 809, a ribeye at 12.9, IMF at 3.6, and a back fat at 0.2. The pen average weight per day of age was 2.42. This pen, once again, is brought to you by DeYoung Ranch. The DeYoung Ranch was established in 1948 with the emphasis on producing quality livestock that work. Whether it be quarter horses or beef cattle, using multi-trait selection and evaluation of performance data influences each management decision. The three top reasons that we used Maine Anjou Genetics back in 1971 are still true today. 1, add skeletal width with increased muscle mass. 2, increase docility. And 3, complement the quality of Angus carcass traits while enhancing cutability and trimness. We continue to use Maines for their balance in the cattle industry, and we believe they continue to prove to us that the breed's influence rises to meet the standards of the beef industry. We feel these cattle do this while holding firm to the quality of maternal traits, feed efficiency, docility, and eye appeal to make them successful in any realm of beef production. We love the eye appeal and power that has traditionally made them desirable for the show ring. Yet when done right, they make some of the most functional and productive mothers that have long-term value. Again, this was entry 40609 by the Young Ranch. Next entry coming in is 40610, brought to you by Diamonds in the Rough Cattle Company. The first bull in the ring is DRCC Kingsman. He is the first one on your list. He's a March 15th of 2022. He weighed 1137, had a ribeye of 14.9, an IMF at 2.9, a scrotal of 34, and a back fat at 0.2. Again, this is DRCC Kingsman. The next bull in is the bull in the middle of your list there, DRCC Keeping Time. He's a February 19th of 2022. He weighed 1,082, had a ribeye of 15.4, an IMF at 3.1, a scrotal at 35, and back fat at 0.3. Again, this is DRCC Keeping Time. And the final member of this pen of entry 40610 is DRCC Kinetic. He's a February 15th of 2022. He weighed 1,125, had a ribeye of 13.7, IMF at 2.3, scrotal at 36, and back fat at 0.2. Again, the pen average weight per day of age was 3.38 for the pen, brought to you by Diamonds in the Rough. Diamonds in the Rough Cattle Company raises and sells Maine Anjou and Shorthorn purebred cattle known from coast to coast for their quality seed stock. Cattle with the DRCC prefix have won champions in every major state, fair, and livestock show in the U.S. and are sought after by many breeders all across America. Diamonds in the Rough is based out of Ooligah, Oklahoma. Next in will be our final entry in this class, 5. This is pin 40611, brought to you by Blind Badger Ranch. The first bull in is in the middle of this group list. This is BBR Knox, 15K. He's a March 22nd of 2022, weighed 1,055, scanned with an eye of 14.9. Had an IMF of 3.3, a scrotal at 34, and back fat at 0.2. BBR Knox 15K is also lot 25 in our bright light cell. The next bull in is actually third on your list for this group. This is BBR Knight Rider, 69K. He's a February 7th of 2022, weighed 1,231 pounds, had a ribeye of 14, an IMF at 4.7, a scrotal of 36, and back fat at 0.4. BBR Knight Rider 69K is also lot 23 in the bright light cell. The final entry in this pen is first on your list. This is BBR Kingston, 68K. He's a February 7th of 2022. Had a weight of 1275, scanned with a ribeye of 15.6, an IMF at 3.7, scrotal at 38, and back fat at 0.3. BBR Kingston is also lot 22 in our Bright Light cell. This pen, once again, was brought to you by Blind Badger Ranch. It's located in Fort Morgan, Colorado, and is owned by Jim Hett and Bud Gamel. Jim and Bud established the ranch south of Fort Morgan in 1999 when they purchased 12,000 acres of pasture and dryland farm ground. Blind Badger Ranch now consists of 6,800 acres of dryland and 700 acres of irrigated ground that supports wheat, millet, corn, and hay. In addition, they run 9,000 acres of pasture grass. Their 500-head cow-calf operation consists primarily of Maine Anjou, Angus, and Simmental-influenced females. Their breeding program consists of an extensive artificial insemination and ET program. Their program is designed for calving in January through May. The pairs are then ran on native grasses through the summer. A group of calves will be hand-picked and broke in preparation for private treaty sales in the fall. Bull calves are sold at the Cattlemen's Congress, and the remainder are offered private treaty there at the ranch.
Once again, a really good set of bulls that come to us from three different operations. And I think as we sort through these cattle, I think there's a set that really comes to the top of the class, and that's a set up here in front. I think three big, rugged, powerful individuals, and they dictate that on paper as well. And I think they got some scrotal underneath them. They've got some volume. They've got some rib shape, and the data tells us that they have rib shape. Just really rugged individuals. I think there's one really good individual in this set that really catches my eye, but I think they really sit together as three individuals there, as a group, probably more complete in that aspect than any other set here today in this class. We're going to follow them up with the big rugged bulls here that in second in class. I think calves that you really appreciate for their width and their length of body. Maybe a couple bulls, maybe not quite to the same standard as one individual in here. I really appreciate this one bull closest to me. I think a calf that really catches your eye when he came into the ring. But I think overall, really good set of bulls, kind of rugged and got a lot of usefulness in the industry. Bulls come just in third place, maybe a little greener in their makeup. I really appreciate their correctness and their structural integrity. Calves that maybe like to see a little bit more maturity, but they're the youngest bulls in the class. Just get outpowered in terms of power and width and performance compared to the other two. But once again, let's congratulate these operations bringing these cattle out in front of us here today.
Okay, results of Class 5. First place went to Blind Badger Ranch with entry 40611. Second place went to entry 530835, brought to you by Diamonds in the Rough Cattle Company. And our third entry, sorry about that, went to 609, brought to you by the Young Ranch. We have one more class left, Class 6. With our fall bulls, we just have one entry in that class. They will come in the order of 3-2-1 according to your program there, if you're following along. The first bull in the ring is TLLC Jammin. He's a November 6th of 2021. He weighed 1,514 pounds, scanned with a ribeye of 17.5, had an IMF at 3.8, a scrotal at 37, and back fat at 0.3. TLLC Jammin is also lot 21 in our Bright Light cell. The next bull coming in is TLLC Judd. He is a November 4th of 2021. He had a weight of 1,386 pounds, scanned with a ribeye of 15.3, had an IMF of 4.1, a scrotal at 37, and back fat of 0.3. TLLC Judd is lot 20 in the Bright Light cell. And our final member of this pen is TLLC Jed. He's an October 15th of 2021. He weighed 1,189 pounds, scanned with a ribeye of 16.0, an IMF at 3.7, a scrotal of 34, and back fat at 0.2. The pen's average weight per day of age was 2.95. This pen has been brought to you by Team T-Bone. Team T-Bone, the Loudon family from Creston, Iowa, has had Maine Anjou cattle for 30 years. They currently run approximately 80 head of Maine's Maine Tainer and Maine Angus cows. They have cattle for sale year-round, and they are also consigning a great set of purebred Maine Anjou and Maine Angus heifer calves to the Red Dirt Purple Banner sale in Oklahoma in March.
As we've said all day long, let's really congratulate these exhibitor of this operation, bringing a set of bulls to town. Takes a little bit more tough time when you get a little bit more age on these bulls to get them presented. I think these three individuals, when they sit together, a little bit difference in their type and their design. I think two bulls fit together a little bit more uniform. One calf, a little bit more moderate, really appreciate his structure and his width and his power. But I think three bulls in their own right are going to go out and sell and help support the industry. They got some rib shape, and they got some mass, and they got some stretch. So let's, as they walk out, let's congratulate this operation bringing these bulls to town today for us.
Okay, coming back for our final drive here in our Champion Manage U Penta 3 Bulls show. Representing Class 4, first place went to entry 40607, brought to you by Ulrich's Cattle Company. Representing Class 5, first place in that class went to entry 40611, brought to you by Blind Badger Ranch. And representing Class 6, entry 40612, brought to you by Team T-Bone. Again, our judge today has been Mr. Sean Wilson. Sean, along with his wife Stacy and sons Jason Caden, operates SW Cattle Company, a seed stock operation based in Strathmore, Alberta, and La Rose, Saskatchewan. Please put your hands together and show Sean our appreciation for coming down to judge our pen cattle today. Thank you, Sean.
Well, I guess this is about the last time I get to talk today, where someone will listen. It's indeed an honor to come down and sort through these cattle. I don't take it by any means, take my decision lightly. I know how much work and effort it takes to get these cattle to town, and I really have to admire and congratulate all the exhibitors today for bringing out a tremendous set of individuals and groups in front of us. I think this breed, our family's been in it for well over 50 years. It's come a long ways. I mean, we've seen some full bloods today, and we've seen these purebred cattle, high percentage cattle, and I think I lost my mom last year, and she loved this stuff, and she loved this breed, and we've been in it a long time. And I really appreciate the quality of the cattle, but more so the people. And I think with that, as we go through the cattle, and I have to apologize for my emotions, but I know in this agriculture that we're in, and I don't take it lightly, we feed the world. And we produce an animal that we want to look at and we're proud of, but at the end of the day, we put food on the table for the nation and for the world. And I think as we go forward with these cattle, we have to appreciate the quality that we have and the benefits that we can give to the industry. Not just in the show ring, but out in the pastures. We spent the last 2 days out in this country, went to a couple operations in a rugged country, and these cattle work. We don't have to have halters. We don't have to feed them. These cattle get out, and they'll work for the commercial man. And I think with that, by looking at the cattle that we've had today, we're in good hands going forward. There's a lot of quality. There's a lot of opportunity. There's a lot of beef cows in this country that can use these genetics. So with that, we're going to use this pen right here as your champion. I'm not going to say there's definitely some issues with these bulls. I wish they had a little bit more scrotal, but they're young, but they really sit together really well, and there's a couple of really good individuals. And I look forward to seeing the pen, the second place pen, because they're a really good set too, and we've got a really tough decision for reserve. But let's congratulate all the exhibitors and your champion pen right here.
Congratulations to entry 40607, brought to you by Ulrich's Cattle Company. Coming in second out of class four was entry 40608, brought to you by Buck Morton Cattle Company. Would like to remind everyone once again, many of these animals will also be in our Bright Lights sale this afternoon. Preview will start about 1:45 in the Ford Arena. Also, many of these cattle, well, all of them are stalled in the west end of Barn 4 if you'd like to look at them before then. And then follow up and join us for the main exchange sale at 5:30 this evening. If you have any questions, please come by our booth located in the Ford Barn. We'd be glad to assist you in any way.
Guess I was wrong. I get one more chance. As I said earlier, we really have to appreciate the quality, and I think this the class one second place set really were, that was a really tough decision in that class. And as they come back out in the championship, they're very competitive, and you really have to appreciate their type and their quality and their depth. And I think class two winners are very, very similar in their type. I think obviously, it's between these two pens for your reserve championship. I think as I analyze these cattle, and I'm going to critique them, and I mean, I'm going to sort them the way we do our own. And as I said earlier, I'm just giving you guys my opinion today, kind of what works for our operation. My grandpa used to say, ask me what a good cow was, and I told him they had to be this, this, and this. And he said, no, a good cow makes you money. A poor cow loses you money. So I'm not here to tell you what kind of cattle to run. They're making you money. They're good cattle. And I think there's, as we go forward in this industry, there's some pretty good times ahead of us. We're going to have a lot of good cattle out there. But with that, we're going to go. We're going to use the second place pen as your reserve champion, a really close placing. But once again, I think as let's congratulate these exhibitors that brought these cattle, and good luck with the sale later today. And thanks for having me, and look forward to seeing everybody down the road.
Reserve champion went to entry 40608, entry from Buck Morton Cattle Company. Thanks again for joining us for our Maine As You Pen show. Please come by and see us this afternoon for our Bright Light sale at 2:30 p.m. in the Ford Arena. Also, join us for the Maine Exchange Frozen Genetics sale, which will be in the Cattlemen's Congress Barn Bar at 5:30.
P&K Equipment has been in the John Deere business for nearly 40 years. Down to our very roots, we're connected to the land and to our customers. P&K is built on customer service. Since the beginning, our valued employees have delivered the right solutions at the right time for a positive P&K experience. We know you've got a choice when it comes to where you shop. So if you entrust P&K with your next equipment purchase, we promise you a memorable experience. Start building your own P&K experience at pkequipment.com.
Cattle identification and record keeping should be easy. Tie your visual tag, EID tag, and genetic data to one management number with AllFlex matched sets. AllFlex Livestock Intelligence. We help you bring it all together.
Your legacy is not only where you came from, but more importantly, it's where you're headed. With our toolbox of reproductive technologies, exceptional team of professionals, and more than 40 years of experience, we continue to create future leaders. Whether it's advancing superior genetics or empowering the next generation of livestock producers, you can trust Transova to continue your legacy.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have resolved our minor technical difficulties and we are ready to begin our 2023 National Shorthorn and Shorthorn Plus Pin Show here at the Cattlemen's Congress. If you have not found a program, there are programs around the arena here. If you would like one, you'll also be able to follow along with the pin information and data on the screen above us as we go about our show. Today's show will start with the Shorthorn Plus Female Show. Class number one is spring heifer calves, those that are calved March 1st of 2022 or after. And we have two entries in this class, two entries in class number one today. Our judge for our national pin show is Mr. Troy Thomas of Harold, South Dakota. He operates Thomas Ranch, which is a fourth-generation family outfit with his wife and daughter. They raise Charolais, Angus, Red Angus, and Simmental cattle and market 400 bulls annually. Troy has judged shows across the country as well as Mexico and Canada. His family has raised and showed national champions in all four of those breeds. To kick our day off right, if you would, please give our judge, Mr. Troy Thomas, a warm welcome here to the Cattlemen's Congress. Our first entry in class number one of the Shorthorn Plus heifer calves comes to us from Lazy Bar F Shorthorns of Chickasha, Oklahoma. The first heifer entering the ring should be tattoo number 2003K. Lazy Bar F Shorthorns is owned by Don Ferguson and located in Chickasha, Oklahoma. They have been members of the American Shorthorn Association for almost 20 years now. They run about 150 head of cattle, and they host the Red Dirt Treasure Sale each April. The heifer calves in this pen will be located in pen 2072, and pick of this pen is available tonight at the Summit National Sale. So head back to pen 2072 and check out these heifers and come view them for the offering in tonight's Summit Sale. Our next heifer into the ring should be number 2999. The average age of this pin, average date of birth is July the 14th. Average weight of 634 pounds and weight per day of age of 3.59. As you can see on the screen above, and as well as in your program, you can see the pin averages for other data points and EPDs on these heifers. And here comes heifer 2999. This female was born July the 9th, weighs 652. And then the final heifer in this pen should be tattooed 2824F. She was born July the 23rd, weighed in at 576. This is the third and final heifer for the pen from Lazy Bar F Shorthorns, Chickasha, Oklahoma. These heifers will be in pen 2072 over in the covered arena where all the Shorthorn pens are located. You can check these heifers out. A pick of this pen will be offered tonight in the Summit National Shorthorn Sale. 6 o'clock tonight in the Super Barn Sale Arena, just across the road from where we're sitting right now. This pin of three is the spring heifer calf entry from Lazy Bar F Shorthorns, Chickasha, Oklahoma. Heifer's average date of birth of the pin is July the 14th. Weight of 634, weight per day of age 3.59. Our second entry in this class comes to us from Pearl Valley Shorthorns of Valley City, North Dakota. The leadoff heifer in this pen should be 277K. 277K, born April the 21st, and weighed 787. Pearl Valley Shorthorns, family-run operation overlooking the Cheyenne River just north of Valley City. They raise purebred Shorthorn as well as Shorthorn Simmental composite influence cattle. The herd is managed for superior maternal traits as well as docility and low maintenance. Cattle are consigned annually to the Durham Nation sale in Catherine, North Dakota. Pick of this pen is on offer once again this year in the Summit sale tonight, as well as the pick of their purebred pen will be offered. So the opportunity to get into this Pearl Valley program both on the plus and the purebred side tonight. And females are also offered private treaty off the farm there in Valley City. This is 277K. If you have your Summit catalog, this heifer is lot 13A. Our next heifer in this pen is 114K. This pen of females, average date of birth is March the 25th, average weight of 830, average weight per day of age of 2.90. All the cattle in our pen show today were weighed and carcass scanned at check-in on Thursday. You can see that data in your program as well as up on the screen above. This is heifer 114K. The final heifer in this entry should be tattoo number 136K. Once again, this is the second entry in class one from Pearl Valley Shorthorns, Valley City, North Dakota. Heifer's average date of birth, March 25th, weight of 830, WDA 2.90. Your pick of this trio of heifers is available in tonight's Summit sale at 6 o'clock over in the Super Barn Sale Arena. We will get these heifers haltered back up and bring in our first entry in this class for our judge to make a selection of our first and second place in class number one, the Shorthorn Plus Pen of Three Spring Heifer Calves. We've got our two entries, the one from Lazy Bar F Shorthorns and the Pearl Valley Shorthorns entry, competing for the overall title in class number one. Class two will be on deck. We have one entry in that class. As Judge Thomas looks over these heifers from class number one again, why don't you as exhibitors give these folks a nice hand for bringing these heifers out and exhibit them here at the Cattlemen's Congress today.
Really a nice class here to start off our Shorthorn Plus show this morning with these two pens of heifers. It's a privilege for me to be here in Oklahoma City at the Cattlemen's Congress and be involved in the Shorthorn show this morning, the pen show. I think you brought a really tough class. I realize there's only two entries out here in this class, and I think there's some positives to both pens of heifers. Obviously some age differences and in terms of maturity and the way they've been developed, and I guess you can find a lot of good in both pens, depending on what direction you want to go with your program. I think if you look at the data, there's not a lot of difference. Obviously, the younger heifers have an advantage in terms of weight per day of age. A lot of that's just youth and maturity. Big heifers probably have an advantage just in terms of overall body and depth and softness. I guess, again, just kind of a challenging class. As young pen of heifers, I really like these heifers. A lot of quality in these females. They're not identical. There's sure some differences in them. I guess maybe if as a ideal pen, you'd like to make them a little more uniform, but there's some really unique individuals in there. I think all three of these are awful good heifers, depending on what you want to do with them and how you project them on down the road. I'm sure some junior exhibitors, there's a couple of really neat heifers in there that I think will have a lot of fun in terms of a show career and on down the road. These big heifers, I guess they have an advantage in terms of uniformity. These heifers are built a lot alike. Again, as I said before, they're deep-ribbed, deep-sided, easy fleshing cattle. They're really sound in terms of their structure. I think from a maternal standpoint, this pen definitely, to me, has an advantage just when you project them on down into cows. But again, two great pens, tough decision. I thought maybe if I talked about them a little bit, I could come up and make a decision, but anyway, today I'm going to go ahead and use your big pen to win the class. These younger heifers will be second. Congratulations, two really nice pens.
First place in this class goes to Pearl Valley Shorthorns of Valley City, North Dakota. Second to Lazy Bar F Shorthorns of Chickasha, Oklahoma. Congratulations to both our exhibitors here. And once again, if you saw a heifer you like, you can come to the Summit sale tonight and take your pick of both these pens in the Summit National sale this evening. Our next class will be junior heifer calves, our January-February born females. We have one entry from Sod House Ranch in Brewster, Kansas. The first female in their pen should be number 640. Sod House Cattle is owned by Craig and Billy Hoyt. Located in Brewster, Kansas, they have been in business for 45 years. They offer their cattle private treaty, These cattle are raised on short grass in northwest Kansas in a semi-arid area. They are run on corn and Milo stalks in the winter, and they are real-world cattle, not pampered. These folks would love to visit with you back in the pens and learn more about their program and these heifers. After the conclusion of our show today, please be sure to head over to the South Covered Arena and find the sod house pen. The average date of birth on this pen of heifers is February 14th, weight of 721, WDA of 2.21. Second heifer in this pen should be number 641, 641. The final heifer in this pen is number 637, 637. Heifer weights 751.